turn up. I'm breaking in. I'm at the pearly gates, but they won't let it in. I told the devil, I said, I ain't trying to sin. Yeah. I ain't trying to sin.
I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's the Browns going up against the Titans. With that, let's get up to Tennessee. We're standing by in Nashville, our Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. We welcome everyone to the Music City, just a stone's throw from the Country Music Hall of Fame. We are at Nissan Stadium in Nashville, Tennessee. Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store between the Cleveland Browns and the Tennessee Titans.
In my face, you're not from the clique. Give me space, we might ride it. Most say that, baby, they don't love the clique. I thought they love you when you make it. This some mother. Yeah, this some mother. Friends and business don't mix, so I'm brotherless. Tryna get back close, hit them with the stiff. Gears I shift, make sure they feel the drift. Just cut the bands all with the tick. You should know, cause in every song I said it. Yeah, in every song I said it. I'm just proud of my accomplishments. I'm a 400, I don't care at all. Have a head on, heard you. Tell them about I'm real, I'm fraud. Your kids and broad, ain't straight, you shouldn't care at all.
Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave.
Four times how it go down. Slaps on deck for the whole town. On mama's, man, I did it with my own sound. And I got my own city that I hold down. Just admit it already. You got plans to do it, but we did it already. Got a couple DMs, I done slid in already. Gotta ask YG if he hit it already. Yeah, I'm a star like Moesha's. Running up the numbers like Aisha's. Yeah, I be sliding, I be creeping. Girls these days, they just don't know how to keep it. But I got it all handled. They try to box me and I got my own angles, yeah. I'ma spend the summer getting to the cake and I'ma wishing wood on every candle. I'm like,
please tell me why you are.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's the Browns going up against the Titans. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store between the Cleveland Browns and the Tennessee Titans. Johnson, and he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. A gain of three, second down. And trying to give a lift to this offense today will be the Duke, the former Cane, Duke Johnson.
Comes from a great tradition of runners at Miami of Florida. He's one of the best ones we've seen in recent years.
Second down following the run. Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. His throw incomplete. He was looking for Terrell Pryor that time, and it's third down. The starting defense for the Titans.
Jason McCourty's twin brother Devin has gone to multiple Super Bowls, but Jason's carving out a nice niche himself as a cover corner.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is third and seven. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Josh Gordon, the intended receiver, and it brings up fourth down.
Third down is the down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Start this drive in the air. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll make it a second down.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He sets to fire deep. That one was intended for John Brown. And it's third and short. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. They'll go to the air here on third and two. Hard throw, incomplete. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver. And fourth down coming up.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Now it's Ginn. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And out will come the offense as they take over. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
They begin the drive with Johnson. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8, now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They come out here in the eye. They'll set up a throw. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. Give him 7 on the play, and they're going to have a third down.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw a completion.
Offense coming up, needing 2 yards on third down. Here comes the D swarming to the line. Third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Pryor has it complete. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. In motion goes the tight end. They'll look to throw now on first down. Looking for Gannon. It's intercepted. Picked off by Wesley Woodyard. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession. See if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. And here's the starting crew defensively for Cleveland.
Joe Hayden is a complete cornerback. He tackles, he covers, and does everything with incredible speed.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. They'll drop the throw. And this one caught by Delanie Walker. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. And they talked about how important the passing game was going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation, it's all about planning, and then it's about execution. So put it all together in practice. Okay, this is what we think we're going to see. This is how they get to it. And then when the game comes, read it and attack it.
All right, here we go.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
A 1 yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down.
Here we go now. Blue landing.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on 3rd down and 9. They're going to look to throw. He gets it to Brown, complete. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add a little extra at the end with a short run.
And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Second down following the incompletion. Again, he'll drop to throw. And a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he locates Luke Wilson. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Luke Wilson, his second touchdown on the season. And the Titans have taken a first quarter lead. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away. And the kick goes outside the white lines. That's why the flag comes out.
Yes, and that was an error by the kicker, and it will give the offense great starting field position.
And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Second down following the run.
All right, here we go.
Good.
They go to Johnson again. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run.
Here we go now. 3-19. 3-19. No. Check. Patriot. Now let's go.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson. A big gain there on third and long. 34 yards.
Well, I'd have to say in that situation, they're lined up for a running play. It's only third and two. Some element of the pass, but that was really well blocked.
Probably call those gravy plays, right, if you're the offensive coordinator?
No doubt about it. All you're trying to do is get the 2 yards necessary for a first down. Then you look up, you've got a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, they did. They got a lot more than that indeed. And now a first down following that long gain. They come up in an offset eye. The first down carry here for Johnson. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12.
No. Check. Patriot.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. The throw to the left side, caught by Coleman. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's a gain of 5, and that's going to lead to a third down. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The Browns with a football to begin quarter number 2. They're on the march, but facing a third down here. They'll throw. Now this is brought in by Pryor. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Terrell Pryor, his third touchdown now on the year. And his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead. And it's no good. He missed it. And the game remains tied. Oh, boy. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. And a short kick, taking it about the 16. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
The defense came out with a look that they had prepped for all week to attack. They took advantage, got the first down.
And the key words in there, prep for all week. They really studied them, understood their tendencies, knew what they liked to do, and prepared their game plan accordingly. And boy, the payoff was good.
And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down of the offense in search of 6 yards.
Now let's go.
They'll set up to throw. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They come out here in the eye. On second down, Johnson. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They stay on the ground on first with Johnson. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And they're definitely showing blitz here.
Let's go!
They'll drop the throw. Pryor has it complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
They'll run it with Johnson. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only 1 on that play.
The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Flush to his right. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Offense in a little bit of a bind here. 9 yards to go on 3rd down. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Out of the gun now on 3rd down. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Out come the Titans now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So they complete the pass, and now they face a 2nd down.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A big play that time on the catch and run. And it's going to yield a new set of downs. They'll look to throw here on 1st down. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball, you must have a lot of confidence or you think you're really going to fake them out. And it looks like they did exactly that.
Yeah, going deep in the playbook and a great grab on the other end.
He's thrown 1 interception already, and that doesn't necessarily mean the rest of the game is going to go like that. But it does seem that he's a little bit off in his approach to this one.
Yeah, it does. And that was a risky throw right there.
Got to be careful about taking care of the ball, making sure you get back within yourself. I mean, those mechanics that they work on all the time, they're there for a reason. Kind of get back to those and maybe tamp it down a little bit.
He's got Wilson, middle of the field. And he's brought down. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Back it up, Billy.
Play clock winding down. And they'll run it here. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. Back to Tennessee after this. Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And right with it here over the middle. It'll be a gain of six, and that'll make it third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six.
Now let's go.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one.
And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Luke Wilson, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Titans are able to strike for six. So they're going to go for two. They'll look to throw, and unable to connect. They don't get the two-point conversion here.
Well, partner, since this new two-point rule came into play, offenses spend a lot more time working on it. That means the defenses are doing the exact same thing.
There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
And no, not quite at that level and not at that age. But I remember looking over at him, and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about? It's because he had enough confidence in himself that was a fluke. And he went out and played pretty well the rest of the day.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Flushed out right, and they'll take him down. And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And now it's a third and four situation for the offense.
Detroit!
All right, here we go.
3-19!
Back to throw. He finds Coleman, and he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Throw now on first down. Pryor has it complete.
He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he's got his man on the out route. Call it a gain of 5. And that'll bring up second down.
If you run an out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
All right, here we go.
And he motions
Green,
the wide receiver.
Green, 39.
Back to throw again. That's complete. It's Gordon. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Second and 10. He'll look to throw again. Sideline throw. It's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
This will be the eighth play of the drive, and it's third and inches. They come out here in the eye. On third down, Johnson. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. So it'll be first down here after the run.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue lining.
They'll bring a receiver in motion left. They'll bring a receiver in motion right.
No. Check. Patriot.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. To the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. They come out here in the eye. Johnson, and he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Duke Johnson in the final seconds of the first half. And the Browns can grab the lead if they hit the extra point.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. And it's no good. He missed it. And the game remains tied. Oh, boy. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. It's a short kick, taken at the 15. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. It's a very short kick taken by an up man. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
All right, here we go.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. That is incomplete. The tight end, Luke Wilson, was the target. And it's third down.
There are a good number of coaches that any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down.
All right, here we go.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position. And now the Browns offense trots back onto the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Back to throw here. It's brought in right side by Ginn. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now
Johnson, and he's brought down. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Here we go now. Ooh, landed.
They'll send Ginn in motion left. They'll look to throw here on first down. Ginn has it complete. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Second down now after the pass completion. Here's Johnson, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a third and three.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up to play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down. They'll look to throw here. And this is going to be incomplete.
Really good, smart play by the defense, understanding third and short, guarding the first down sticks, and being able to make a play on the football and bat it down.
No signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Green 39! Green 39! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Hurry up, here we go! Blue, gone, gone! Gone, gone!
They'll look to throw. And it is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good. But when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that loosened up things a little bit, Walter. Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
And that one results in 35 yards.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
Here we go now. 319.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And Walker with it over the middle. And he'll get it down here to the 43. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be a second down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Hurry up, here we go.
He'll look to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Shift together here from the D-line. Now a handoff here to his running back. And a short gain down to about the 33. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation. And now they're in the hurry up. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line.
We can talk about bend but don't break all we want, but the defense now, we're going to find out just how flexible and pliable they really are. Can they bounce back after that type of a run, that type of momentum against them, and find a way to slow down this offense?
And they're going to speed things up here.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends.
And he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Titans are going to take the lead. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments. Let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now the Browns coming out on the field. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit. They're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Again, it's Johnson, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
There are so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills, but how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day, get the blocker away, and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
And the offense moving in the wrong direction here now as they face a second and 12.
No. Check. Patriot. Here we go now. Patriot. 3-19. Detroit. Back down to that Philly. Here we go.
Halfback sent in motion.
Watch it now. Barney.
Now back to throw. Pryor has it complete. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Now let's go. Four now. Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
And the wideout in motion. To throw now on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
There's Johnson. He's been busy this afternoon. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. Johnson running left. And he's going to get this inside the 30. We'll give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. The toss. Here's Johnson. And they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner, but where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end, in the direction they want to run the football? If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
Now Johnson, just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's third and a yard. Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's third and a yard. They come out here in the eye. Johnson, give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be fourth down and a few inches. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Hurry up. Here we go. Green, 39.
Here we go with Johnson. And he is going to lose yardage here. He only needed a few inches, but they stop him behind the line. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this one up to about the 23. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
6 yards to go here on second down. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together.
Now let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A big play there on the catch and run, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. The play clock's running down. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. To throw it. He's got the hook up to John Brown on the right side. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it second down. So the offense readies for a 2nd and 4. Get this down only to about the 46. He got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more. And now the Browns are going to take another timeout. That'll be their 2nd, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. And they're just a couple of yards shy of a 1st down here on 3rd down.
Set, green, 39.
They'll set up to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their 3rd and final stoppage here as we step aside. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on 4th and 1. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he locates Luke Wilson. Give him 3 on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on 4th down. A gutsy decision there, going for it on 4th, but they got it, and that likely puts an end to this one.
Indeed, it was gutsy because there's so many other options they probably could have exercised in that situation, but they bet on themselves, and it paid off.
Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Are you one of those guys that's skeptical about it, or did you trust it?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice, got your notes laminated, because, you know, open-air booth, that rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond his years. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. The Titans are winners here as we say so long from Nashville.